he has to win a championship. I'm not disagreeing with it. But I think that folks who judge him harshly, they're judging the comparisons to Kobe because there's a constant debate as to whether or not LeBron is the greatest ever as opposed to MJ. And you have Laker fans out there saying, what about Kobe? But in terms of the Lakers organization and people embracing him as a part of Laker Nation, that is a different category because the team has stunk over the last five to six years.
You're right.
Hold on. They've stunk over the last 5 of the last 6 years. Not to mention, as a free agent, he elected to come to L.A. He is already a three-time champion. He ain't in pursuit of nothing.
Yeah, no,
he's already done it.
But you got to do it for the Lakers.
And I don't mean for
exactly,
nothing.
These are not, exactly. That makes it seem for him.
These
what about
are not,
for them?
I did afternoon drive in L.A. for almost 6 years. I'm telling you, you got to. And I know you know the L.A. market well. You're there all the time, and you've got a radio show also, which is on in L.A. and used to come on my show in L.A., in fact. So, you know, look. You got to do it for the Lakers. It's different. And I agree, these are not perfect analogies. But in fact, Jeter and A-Rod works for me to an extent, as does Brady and Peyton. You have on the one hand, and LeBron has kind of gotten himself out of the A-Rod, Peyton Manning category. By the way, both those guys won championships. Like, A-Rod and Peyton won championships. But if anything, LeBron, if you have to group them, there's the Jeter, Brady, Kobe category. And I'm not saying Jeter's quite what Kobe or Brady are. But they're the winners. They're the guys who you say it's beyond just the numbers. That's the guy you want. They're the guys who are embraced and loved differently, that you think there's this extra component. And LeBron, for a while, though he's dug himself out of it, was more in the Peyton and A-Rod category. That's the guy that puts up the all-time great numbers. They're so shiny. It's like they're so brilliant. It's almost hard to look at them. But you don't trust them the way you don't feel about them the way you felt about the other guys. There's something you feel like missing in the personality, in the clutch gene or something. Again, not perfect. LeBron's elevated himself out of it. But as it relates to the Lakers, he's going to have to win a championship at least.
That's fine, but there is nothing missing in the personality of LeBron. It's that he's from Akron, Ohio native. He started out his career in Cleveland. He took a hiatus to Miami for 4 years. He came back to Cleveland. Whereas with Kobe Bryant is a lifelong Laker. He's never played for anybody else. And you have to take this into consideration. Jerry West pulls off the heist. Not only does he get Shaquille O'Neal as like a thief in the night from Orlando, okay? But then he pulls off a draft day trade where ultimately you draft Kobe, you know, the Charlotte Hornets draft Kobe Bryant 13th. All right, that's the same draft they drafted Allen. Philadelphia drafted Allen Iverson, number one. Milwaukee drafted Ray Allen and Stephon Marbury, and they flopped. Well, actually, Milwaukee picked Stephon, and they flopped with Minnesota and all of that other stuff. The point is, Kobe Bryant, Jerry West made him a Laker, and he always wanted to be a Laker.
LeBron chose.
So excuse me.
You're kind of making the you got the tap on the shoulder argument. If Kobe says it, you're a Laker.
No. I'm not saying that at all. What I'm saying to you is that LeBron arrives a champion.
Yeah, but and man,
that doesn't matter for the Lakers.
I got to tell you, that's right.
Wait a minute. Hold on.
I'm sorry. Hold on, Max. That makes
y'all are not understanding my point, but go ahead.
Let me ask you guys both this. Sure. Max, you bring up Peyton, you bring up A-Rod. Those guys, as you point out, won championships. Can you give me the best example of a superstar who got welcomed in as a member of the family that didn't bring a championship? I mean, to that family. You brought up Elgin Baylor.
Wait a minute. This is my point. The Lakers have a different standard. Here's what Lakers fans should feel towards LeBron. Here's what they should feel. Grateful. They should feel gratitude. Thank you for choosing us because you didn't have to do that and you're the best player in the game. But in fact, that gratitude will only extend so far. Ultimately, they will be bitter if he doesn't win a championship, and it's because the Lakers have different standards than the fans.
But no
have
one's
different expectations
but,
than any
but,
other
but
basketball
team. But no one's
team.
Refuting that. But y'all are sitting here talking like LeBron James has been there for 2 years. He's been there for 4 games. What I'm saying to you is that ultimately what you have to lean on is that the greatest player in the world, who is a three-time champion, has elected to come and play with us. So that's the mode that Kobe's in. You don't have y'all talking about Laker fans. What the real issue with LeBron is Laker fans who are appalled at the notion that he is better than Kobe. That is the category that he embraces the most vitriol for.
Yep.
They're not judging him for a championship yet Because they only played four games.
Yeah, but Kobe's the one saying he's a member of the family already.
Because Kobe's relieved that they got respect. Hold on, somebody. Do you remember when Kobe Bryant was on Jimmy Kimmel? Do y'all remember that?
Yep.
Do you remember how he looked at Jimmy Kimmel and he looked at that audience? Because Jimmy Kimmel's show, they were on a 14-game losing streak. And Swaggy P and all of those guys finally won a game. And they were celebrating like they won a championship. And the audience was laughing. And Kobe Bryant had a stone face. And he just wouldn't say a word. And Jimmy Kimmel was laughing, like asking him questions. Because he was disgusted. Kobe Bryant came on my radio show the next day after LeBron signs. And Kobe Bryant's like, I come to the game now. You see me at the game now. He said, quote,
Stephen A.,
I was not coming to that trash
I want to get
that
back.
We will watch.
Wait a minute. I want to get back.
That's what he said.
I want to get back real quick before we end it. I want to get back to this. There are Kobe fans. I make this to Kobe fans and Lakers fans. Venn diagram, shaded area, not all exactly the same thing. There are Kobe fans who don't like the fact that they feel like people forgot about Kobe. LeBron, MJ, why are you skipping Kobe? Those fans are always going to prefer Kobe. But if LeBron doesn't win a championship, they're going to go at LeBron.
No doubt.
Therefore,
and I'm saying
to
y'all, who's denying that?
He's going to have to win a championship.
That's what I'm
going to
say. Who's denying that?
No, you're not. You're not. You're not.
Thank
you. I asked you a question, though. I said, can you give me a name of a guy who's been welcomed into a family who didn't win a championship, okay? You said Elgin Baylor. I'm just thinking, who didn't win a championship but still gets a member of the family? Can you read that for me?
Tony Romo.
There you go.
That didn't win a championship.
But a member of the family.
I'm asking you this question.
But
why?
he didn't come from another team.
Why?
He was born into the Cowboys.
I'm just saying. It's hard to find guys that didn't win championships who are full members of the family.
But especially if they've been traded or signed.
Well, let's go to break. Let's go to break on this. We're having a discussion about champions. And Will Cain brought up Tony Romo.
No,